Good to see you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming aboard.
Rick has a background somewhat similar to Ed Hickey's. He's from the Boston area, and obviously he's Italian background with that name of writing. And he's also a Secret Service agent.
Well, for heaven's sakes, yes, that is. I tell you, I will not do to you one thing that I did to Ed Hickey. Well, very early, while I was still governor of California, you know, he was out there, and then finally we took him away from the service to be head of our security and build up our security. Well, we went down to the Wilson's Ranch in Mexico, and first day there, and could have a ride. And our Bill Wilson's Mexican partner mounted him on a horse, and I didn't pay attention. I should have said Boston, I should have said Haas. He was on a Haas. I didn't pay attention. We rode for 3 hours, and this was a first for Ed. But he thought that's what the new thing called for, and he rode, got in, and then I saw, and he just assumed that it was normal and natural. The stirrups and his knees, he was like that, his knees and his legs.
Oh, no,
when he got off the horse, he damn near fell down. His legs wouldn't work. But he just assumed, well, this must be the way it's supposed to be. If I'd even taken one look, I'd
have
no stirrups lengthened for him.
Pretty much. No one hit you. That's funny.
He had trouble walking for about 3 days.
Well, you'll see Rick around now on the plane and various other places.
My pleasure.
Well,
all right.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Chief.
Okay.
What are you saying, buddy?
I think it's love.
Talk to him. He'll talk to you, Hank.
I don't speak that language.
Were you here when I had
George is a turkey. I'm just speaking.
George does a hell of a job.
Were you here when I had the president?
Jason.
Had he? He's right. You know, we weren't getting any action out of him.
Anybody have any questions? Hey,
yeah. Went straight up. He's 28 weeks old. Well, he's 55 pounds.
That's pretty good.
I'm sorry.
55. Rope, 28
Everybody
weeks.
Under the rope. With it. This
Does everybody know the turkey's name? Welford. Right means resolute for peace. Welford.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
Something about the turkey.
What do you think about the turkey?
Turkey answered.
Do you mind if I answer Turkey? He said yes. The turkey's name is Wilfred. And that is a German name, and it means resolute for peace. And so I think it's rather appropriate, not only for the season, but for the particular times that we've just been through here. And I'm glad to say that having done his duty symbolically, he's going to look forward to a long life, a place where children can come in and see him as well as other livestock and animals.
In other words, he's not going to eat him.
What? I don't think it would be right for me to comment on other things and due deference here to our guests who have come, as they always have, for this. This is more than a symbolic gift with this particular bird. They are making available to others who might not have a turkey on Thanksgiving a number of them for us here, and I think that's all we'll keep this subject to what's going on here.
Why did you issue a proclamation today declaring yesterday a day for fasting?
I found out that sometimes the way the Congress works, I declare whole weeks as special weeks before they get the paper to be for signing. People know and understand, and the notification has been given to those interested that the day or the week or the month, whatever it is, has been named. I've wondered about that sometimes in the paperwork that I find myself signing them after the fact. What? Well, I've been waiting for you to invite me.
Not now, when?
Not here? Where? Yes, sir, Wilfred. You let him have it.
All right, Wilfred, you have your facts wrong again.
Well, sir, I agree with everything you said. That's quite a bird.
Oh, he's
60 pounds.
28 weeks.
You don't like me. He's gonna lay an egg on
you.
I tried, fellas. Oh, Lord. What if I didn't try?
Thanks very much. We're all very grateful to these people for their contribution and for the ceremony, which starts off our Thanksgiving season.
Well, we appreciate
that. You got your answer there, Sam. Thank you. That is the calmest presentation you've ever had.
Sertoma International, and we're so proud to bring John Fling to you and have him honor you by this visit.
And I'm honored.
He is a fantastic example of what a man in the private sector single-handedly can do for his community. We're very proud.
And I'm Joe Cooper, the Secretary.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Just one second here, because anyone who travels as much as you do must now and then have to write home, so here's just a little souvenir.
Thank you, sir. You made me feel bad, man. I told these fellas in advance I'm just a different type of guest to be of yours, because I didn't bring anything. I'm not going to ask anything.
No, and this is a classic example.
Thank you, sir.
Volunteerism that is so traditional in our country.
Thank you, sir. God bless you.
Indebted to you.
Thank you, sir. It's a pleasure meeting you.
Mr. President, our organization wants to thank you on behalf of your efforts for peace and humanity throughout the world. Your efforts last week were just fantastic.
Thank you very much.
All the citizens of this country appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
It's another local TV crew. It's basically the same over here. As you think you read, Provale is going to give you the first sheet of Christmas seals. And no gifts for this one. So.
You look like some fellows that were just in. Celebrity chairman have done more, gone farther, traveled more places than anyone who has ever held that position.
Isn't that just like somebody in show business?
It didn't surprise me a bit, because I've known you too long.
Oh,
the thing that we've done, you do it. God bless you.
We try. Indeed, sir. And we have this one here. He's better than last year.
That's the Christmas.
I want you to know I was late when the closing came off in Central Park and Dolly Parton filled in. And as usual, I come with the gifts. We have the seals, which you know.
Yes.
And of course, this is Mrs. Reagan. That's our school man. And we thought of something. We gave you a robe last year. Of a necktie. I told him outside I could see you on the horse with this riding with the necktie.
Oh, I think I'll save that for the White House. It might scare the horse.
And then I said, I'm not seeing too well these days, and I pity pointed this stocking for myself.
Well, bless you.
Yes, I did that. Alone. There's a lot of little holes there. But you're going to have it for a long time.
Well, thank you very much. That will be on my Christmas tree. And now, about these Christmas seals.
Yes.
And I know that's traditional, and I hope that everyone will be getting them and using them. And because I know what's also supposed to go with them, there's a contribution for me for the long
time. You want me to take that and see that it gets back to you?
I want to see that, and again, the American Lung Association or whatever, you went over there and I watched you every step of the way. You did a job.
Thank you.
The red day in the morning, you did.
Thank you.
How you did that after the wakefulness that you had for what, 24 hours at least? Fantastic.
You know, I felt just fine. I don't know how the staff was nodding, but...
I'm a former labor negotiator myself, but I sit on the other side of the table. So, from where you sat, but I imagine that was a negotiation experience that you never had before.
Yeah, and it was most interesting. Let's say, I don't think that I changed his mind about a number of things, but he certainly didn't change mine. But it was really, it was all done in a in a way that's been a little different than, I mean, from his standpoint. Than, I've met with Romeiko and the others over the years, but no, we had good meetings, and even where we disagreed, we weren't disagreeable.
That's my point. Well, I don't think you could.
I was watching,
maybe
you know,
he didn't get your Irish dander.
You know, I went last March to Russia, and when I went last March to Moscow and Leningrad doing that, and I watched him very carefully, and you said a great line, you know. You said, as an actor, you could see when somebody is acting and reacting, but you know what I love? He might have acted, but you know what happened? Because you're a good actor, you had him react a couple of times.
Pearl, could you just hold this up? Are you presenting this to President Reagan?
All right.
And you get.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thanks.
Thank you. I really appreciate your time.
I sure will. She's going out on the coast all day. She's doing things out there. Thank you.
Mr. President, how are you?
How are you?
I'm just on my way to the neutral country which you have returned from, because after having the privilege of serving you here for the past 2 years, I'm joining Ambassador Whittlesey to work on some public diplomacy on Central America, and especially SDI.
Well,
so it's been a great honor working for you here, and I look forward to further service in Switzerland.
Well, then you're not really leaving us, you're just moving across the aisle.
Exactly, sir. And I wanted you to know that I had been in Managua just 2 weeks ago, visiting Cardinal Obando y Bravo, leaders in every sector of the civic opposition there. And I wanted you to have my little report giving you some of the eyewitness accounts of what have taken place there since the Sandinista crackdown of the 15th.
Well, thank you very much. I'll read that with great interest.
As grim as that may be, the words of hope are here from our other friends, like Prime Minister Charles from Dominica, and our other friends in the Caribbean and Latin America, which, thanks to your National Endowment for Democracy, is some of the work that was done here this past summer.
Well, all right, thank
you. So the good news and the bad news together here.
And since you may want to write home or something, just a little souvenir so you won't forget us.
Thank you so much.
Well,
God bless you.
Thank you. God bless you.
Bye-bye.
Last but not least, there's a girl by the name of Marcie Head. She worked in her last two campaigns, worked in the advance office, worked very closely with Ed Rollins, and we had a real nice one for her today. You gotta be careful if you tip too far forward and fall out. Marcie Head. And she is leaving to go to work for the Senate Campaign Committee.
Well, hi, how are you?
You have a present for me?
I'm here for you.
Oh, this one is wonderful.
So, I'll put it on the campaign trail, and I don't think you want to carry it along, but...
Yeah, but I'll put it on my desk.
Yes, tilt it too far, it might fall.
Oh, I won't do that.
The lid is on the bottom.
Okay, thanks very much. Working for you has been the most exciting thing I've ever done.
Well, bless you, and thank you very much, and I...
We'll see you on the
wish you well in what you're doing.
We need it.
Got to have that Senate lead.
We'll do it.
Okay, look at the camera.
Oh,
yeah,
okay. Thanks. Bye-bye.
Bye.